Hello friends, hope all of you and your families are safe during these times. In the next few minutes, I am going to take you through the key events of the recent past and Kotak Mutual Fund's view on equity markets. As the COVID cases in wave 2 continued to drop off, we saw normalization of economic activity. Various high frequency indicators, be it e-way bills, power demand or toll bills, all of these are pointing to increased economic activity. This rub-off was felt in equity markets as well. While May 2021 witnessed strong performance across the board, June was clearly the month for mid and small caps. For the month, mid-cap and small-cap indices outperformed Nifty by about 4 to 5 percentage points. We now have the highest outperformance by mid-cap and small-cap indices over Nifty in any calendar year 6-month period from 2000. The month of June witnessed significant global events. Federal Reserve meeting, to crude continuing to be on the boil. Among local factors, the earnings season for the quarter ending March 2021 came to a close. Besides this, government along with RBI presented additional measures to aid MSME businesses and the poor and needy. Another factor that was closely tracked was the pace of vaccination against COVID. Let's examine each of these in some detail. First, the global factors. Federal Reserve meeting sprung few surprises as the Fed took on note stronger than expected inflation levels along with improving economic strength in US. Given this, there was reference to two aspects. Prospects of tapering of the Fed balance sheet sooner than earlier anticipated. There was also a change in the dot plots, which conveys a stance of interest rate hikes sometime in 2023 for now. Both these measures meant a big surge in the dollar index, even as global bonds fell. While most commodities cooled off for a bit post the announcement, crude continues to be on a boil. Despite the surge in prices, rigs for shale production are significantly lower than pre-COVID levels. This has meant prices are more determined by OPEC now, and they have been slower to increase capacities, maximizing prices for now. Now to local factors. Earnings for the quarter ending March continued to be very strong, led by metals, cement, banks and technology services companies. While June quarter will be subdued in relation to the March 2021 quarter, given COVID wave 2, markets are more keen to see if India Inc. can continue on the strength and momentum it displayed in the last three quarters. Led by strong profit numbers, we now see balance sheet of India Inc. to be in its finest shape over the last many years. This augurs well for the next round of investment that they will do. And we have already started seeing some announcement of investment, be it in the cement, steel, renewable or infrastructure sectors. RBI and government announced some initiative to provide credit support to the stressed sectors as well as provide increased subsidy for fertilizers and longer support on food grains till Diwali. At the margin, these initiatives are well balanced without straining fiscal significantly, even as they provide support to the needy. As far as vaccination is concerned, it is heartening to see significant improvement in coverage, especially towards the end of the month. Almost 37% of the 18 plus population in India has got one shot. If one were to split between districts with 75% or more urban population, 62% of 18 plus population has got one dose of vaccine. Given more economic activity emanating from these urban centers, this pace of vaccination is indeed very encouraging. Rural continues to lag for now at 34% of 18 plus having got one shot, and this needs to be fastened over the next few months. With respect to institutional flows in the markets, both FII and DII were buyers for the month. FII have been buyers of approximately 5,500 crores, whereas DII have bought approximately 1,600 crores worth till 29 June 2021. With this investment in June, FIIs have invested approximately 36,000 crores in calendar year 2021 and DII, which were significant sellers in the first few months, are now just marginal sellers of approximately 4,000 crores. Retail participation continues to be very strong. However, when looked into the context of the huge household savings, even the surge in demat accounts and retail participation that we keep reading about, either directly through stocks or through mutual funds, it's only about 5% of incremental savings that households have channelized to equities for now. This clearly demonstrates the long runway of allocation to equities in the long term. With this strong showing in equities, valuations are fairly valued given expectations of strong earnings cycle in firm footing. While longer term asset class from equities, be it large caps, mid caps or small caps, say over the last 5 or 7 years, are still modest, over the last 15 months we've seen a very strong showing with very little volatility. Given that ups and downs are part and parcel of asset class like equities, it is only natural to expect higher volatility in the times ahead. However, rather than obsessing over the fear of fall, we would encourage investors to use such opportunities to increase allocation to equities, especially if one is significantly underweight in this asset class, as is the case for majority of Indians. Given this, a disciplined asset allocation with a focus on longer term goals is imperative, and equities continue to be an important avenue to fulfill longer term goal obligations. Be patient, investors, and do remember, time in the market is more important than timing the market. Thank you and stay safe.
Mutual fund investments are subject to market risks. Read all scheme-related documents carefully.